It is so cold out there. But there are rivers and seas here. Why haven't we considered terraforming this moon instead of Mars? What are the challenges before considering a visit to this moon of Saturn? Let's discuss whether we can terraform Titan in today's video of DiscoverZen. Saturn's largest moon, Titan, is an icy world whose surface is completely obscured by a golden hazy atmosphere. The surface of Titan is one of the most Earth-like places in the solar system. It is the second largest moon in our solar system next to Jupiter's moon Ganymede, which is just 2% larger than Titan. In comparison, Titan is bigger than Earth's moon and larger than even the planet Mercury, but just 40% the size of planet Earth. This mammoth moon is the only moon in the solar system with a dense atmosphere, and it's the only world besides Earth that has standing bodies of liquid, including rivers, lakes, and seas on its surface. Like Earth, Titan's atmosphere is 95% nitrogen, plus a small amount of methane, which is 5%. But water is available in the form of ice. Titan's temperature remains around negative 292 degrees Fahrenheit, or negative 179.6 degrees Celsius. Beneath Titan's thick crust of watery ice, there are oceans primarily consisting of water rather than methane. Titan takes 15 days and 22 hours to complete a full orbit of Saturn. Titan is also tidally locked in synchronous rotation with Saturn, so Titan always shows the same face to the planet as it orbits. Now let's discuss the challenges of visiting and terraforming Titan. First requirement is to increase the temperature of Titan, which can be done by increasing the greenhouse gases in Titan. There are other options too. Titan has a lot of hydrocarbons and methane, which can be used for power generation. We could stay in controlled environments like circular dome structures. Oxygen won't be an issue as there is an abundance of frozen water in the form of ice available on Titan. This icy water can be used to produce oxygen for humans. People living on Titan could walk around, or rather, bounce around, since the gravity here is only 14% of Earth's gravity. So, the gravity will be the only issue here, but we can exercise to cope with the negative effects of weak gravity, similar to what astronauts do in International Space Station. We can also use hydroponic farming on Titan, as it is done on Earth on a small scale. On Titan, we just need to scale it up. All of this sounds good, but what stops us from colonizing Titan? The only huge challenge we have left is the distance from Earth. Titan is located approximately 1.2 billion kilometers, or 745 million miles away from Earth. The Voyager spacecraft took 3 years and 2 months to reach this distance. But if we're sending a manned mission, it would take at least 4 years to reach Titan. So we understand that our current technology limits us from being able to explore the cosmos. But what if we created a technology that would allow us to travel interstellar distances in a snap? What if we built a working warp drive? That sounds like a different video to speculate and investigate on DiscoverZen.